What's good on YouTube? Welcome back everyone, this is Lee, and yes, today's the day we'll be talking about the Nikon Z6II autofocus for wildlife. So without further ado, let it begin. Now the Nikon Z6II, this camera right here, I mean, you guys saw my videos, I made four of them already. Yeah, I'll leave the link down below, but yeah, a lot of you guys were very shocked to see what I kind of showed you guys. I mean, many folks out there just show one image and they're very excited for the camera, right? They don't show the process in getting that photo. They'll tell you that, oh wow, Nikon Z6II, excellent wildlife camera, right? But once you guys saw my video, you guys were shocked. You guys felt betrayed. You guys were like, wow, I didn't know it did that. Yes, you guys saw the autofocus, right? It did not track that well. You guys saw the subject tracking, the animal focus, and also you saw the blackouts and lag, and many folks were like, wow, thank goodness I bought a DSLR. Yes, I would prefer you guys to go and out and buy DSLR for wildlife photography, because right now the Nikon Z6II isn't that good for wildlife photography. It's a step behind DSLR in my opinion. It's not that great right now, because I just came back from the Canon R5, and basically they were able to snap on the subject no matter what. The camera could recognize the bird. This system right here does not recognize what a bird is. It doesn't know what a bird even looks, because when you have it on animal tracking, by the way, I know it's for cats and dogs. I mean, they had a pet mode that was for cats and dogs. Now they change it to animal tracking, still cats and dogs. It's the same tracking for the same two species, but they just renamed it differently, I guess. Maybe it's for marketing, maybe it's for the future updates, who knows. But anyways, this animal tracking on this system does not track birds. Does not track the insects like the R5. It just does not. It doesn't even recognize it. Basically, the camera was telling me, what is that thing? I don't know what is that. I don't recognize it. It's not part of my algorithm. It's not part of my machine learning. I don't know what that thing is that's flying around in the scene. This camera does not detect it at all. And I know many folks out there are probably questioning, why do we need that? Well, we have blackouts in the camera. So whenever we take a photo, we're always falling behind time. So when we do that, we need to recompose the shot, try to get the subject back in frame again, and it just gets kind of annoying. So having an autofocus that tracks the bird ahead of time basically makes our life a lot easier. I feel that Nikon should definitely get into that direction with animal tracking, because it'll be a great user experience with wildlife. Actually, if they get that in their firmware on this camera, this is going to be a great wildlife camera. But currently right now, it does not have it at all. It does not track birds that well if you set it to animal tracking or any kind of tracking. It just doesn't follow that well unless you use dynamic area autofocus, which you saw, right? You saw the dynamic area autofocus. I mean, it's a great setting. I mean, it could track anything as long as you focus on it. And the downside is the blackouts. Pretty much the blackouts were the only thing for the dynamic area autofocus. So it's just not an intuitive experience. So I did not like that at all. Now, with the subject tracking, you guys saw the subject tracking, right? It was weird. I mean, it was good at one point. I mean, when it was chasing the plane around the scene, but once it's further away, it does not even recognize it, even though that's the only thing in the scene that's actually moving. So hopefully Nikon update that firmware for that, because that was kind of weird. I mean, the plane was so far away, all by itself, isolated, moving really slow, and the camera cannot subject track that at all. So that was pretty bad. And also, yeah, it doesn't subject track the bird at all. I mean, it's pretty bad. I mean, I think I got about maybe 3% success rate on the birds. It was not that great. The only time that would actually work is if the bird is about 3 feet close to you. That's it. The bird was far away, it does not track at all. Does not track at all. So that was a downer for me. Now, all in all, this camera is definitely new. Yeah, this is about 1 month old, and hopefully down the road they get into this whole firmware updating, the autofocus tuning, because Canon right now, even though Canon R5, R6, they do have their problems. They're overheating and all that shenanigans going on over there. They do have good autofocus algorithms for their dual pixel too. They can track the animals successfully. It just snaps on like that. No question asked, it just snaps on. It knows what a bird is. Now, if Nikon could fix all of these issues, this camera is gonna be totally different in the future than today, right? So that's something that we need to keep an eye on. So definitely keep an eye on this camera on all the firmware updates. It's going to be a lot of firmware updates in the upcoming futures probably. So with that in mind, thank you guys for checking me back. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Definitely click like and subscribe. And yep, I guess I'll see you guys in the next one. All right, take it easy. Peace.
Thank you.